Grant.
On the campus of Southeast Community College,
nice job.
These adults learn a new language. For one student, speaking English means she can tell her story in her own words.
My name is Shireen Jordo Alhainto.
For now, Shireen depends on a Kurdish interpreter. Her story is terrifying.
I had told my family members I have my name tattooed on my hand so you guys will know who I am.
This tattoo, a grim reminder of her life as a sex slave under the control of ISIS. But before you hear the unimaginable story of torture, rape, and kidnapping, take a look at her life before as a Yazidi in northern Iraq, taking care of her 10 siblings after her parents died.
It was a simple life. We were living a happy life, and there's nothing to worry about.
Yazidis are a peaceful people, a religious minority. But ISIS had plans to convert them to Islam at all costs.
They killed thousands of our men, but the ladies, thousands of them also committed suicide just to get away from ISIS. They'd rather be dead than to be in their hands.
Shireen says ISIS captured 47 members of her family in 2014. 17 are still missing, including 3 brothers.
Every day is a hard day for me. It's trying to live another day knowing that my siblings are still missing.
Shireen's kidnappers sold and traded her to other ISIS militants in Syria and Turkey.
After they beat me and electrocuted me and they broke her nose, and I didn't talk.
The abuse so horrific even ISIS didn't want her anymore. They reduced her to this. When she arrived at a refugee camp, she couldn't walk.
All I can imagine is what ISIS had done to me.
More than 700,000 Yazidi people lived in northern Iraq. When ISIS tore through the country in 2014, they slaughtered more than 4,000 and trapped thousands more. Nearly all of them had to flee their homes. Some, like Shireen, ran half a world away, landing here in Lincoln, Nebraska. For her, it's as close to home as she can get. The city in America's middle is home to the nation's largest group of Yazidi refugees.
Immediately, you just feel her broken heart.
The community helped this survivor.
You want her to know that she's welcome here and that she's safe here and that we're happy that she's here and that we're happy that she's alive.
She found a job at McDonald's and she's under doctor's care at Nebraska Medicine.
And our big question is this, right?
She says ISIS doctors operated on her without her permission, even removing some of her reproductive organs.
She woke up after surgery and has a large incision on her abdomen and was not told the purpose for it.
While American doctors help her heal, Shireen finds strength in sharing her story. She's learning a universal language to make more people aware of the atrocities, and she's not giving up hope she'll see her loved ones again.
I wake up every morning hoping that I would hear some news that they're still alive and I could reunite with them every day.
Michelle Bandour, KETV, Newswatch 7.